Hi, today we will talk about the drugs used in the management of glaucoma. Before moving to the drugs, we will very briefly look as to what is glaucoma and the aqueous humor dynamics. As we all know that glaucoma occurs due to an increased intraocular pressure. The normal intraocular pressure is 10 to 20 millimeter mercury, and increased intraocular pressure refers to a pressure of more than 21 millimeter mercury. Initially, glaucoma is not associated with symptoms. However, if it is not treated, the persistent increase in intraocular pressure leads to damage to the optic nerve, which may result in blindness. Now coming to the aqueous humor dynamics. In the figure, the cut section of the eye is depicted, where we have the lens depicted in pink, the iris in brown, the cornea in green, the yellow refers to the ciliary body, and the black refers to the trabeculae. Now the space between the iris and the lens is called posterior chamber, and the space between the iris and the cornea is called the anterior chamber. Now we look at the flow of aqueous humor. The aqueous humor is continuously secreted by ciliary processes in the ciliary body. It then flows into the posterior chamber and reaches the pupil. From there, it moves and flows into the anterior chamber. It finally gets absorbed by two outflow pathways, the trabecular outflow, which is via trabecular meshwork and the canals of Schlemm. This accounts for 80 to 95% of aqueous humor drainage, and cholinergic drugs specifically target this pathway. The second pathway is the uveoscleral outflow, which occurs via the ciliary muscle. This accounts for 5 to 20% of aqueous humor drainage, and prostaglandin analogs specifically target this pathway. Now we come to the drugs used in glaucoma. As we know that glaucoma occurs due to either an increased production or decreased outflow of aqueous humor. So the drugs used in glaucoma will act by causing either a decreased production or an increased aqueous outflow. So the first class of drugs causing decreased production are the ocular beta blockers. These are timolol, bitaxolol, levobunolol, and cartiolol. You can remember this by the mnemonic topical beta blockers, which is appearing on the screen. The next class is alpha 2 selective agonists. The drugs available in this class are apraclonidine and brimonidine. We can remember this by A and B. The third class is carbonic anhydrase inhibitors. The drugs available in this class are acetazolamide, brinzolamide, and dorzolamide. Remember A, B, and D. The carbonic anhydrase inhibitors are sulfonamide derivatives. Therefore, their names ends with the letters amide. Now we move to the drugs causing an increased aqueous outflow. They are subdivided into those causing increased trabecular outflow and those causing increased uveoscleral outflow. The drugs increasing trabecular outflow are non-selective alpha agonists such as epinephrine and dipivefrin. Dipivefrin is a prodrug of epinephrine. The second class is cholinomimetic drugs such as pilocarpine, physostigmine, and eicothiophate. Pilocarpine is a direct acting cholinergic drug, which means that it directly stimulates cholinergic receptors, while physostigmine and eicothiophate are indirect acting drugs, meaning that they do not directly stimulate cholinergic receptors, but they increase the concentration of acetylcholine by inhibiting the enzyme acetylcholinesterase. Lastly, in drugs increasing uveoscleral outflow, there is only one class. These are prostaglandin PGF2 alpha analogs. The drugs available in this class are latanoprost, bimatoprost, and tefloprost. Since they are prostaglandin analogs, their names ends with the letter prost. Now, we can make an observation which will help us to remember them in a simpler way. So the left column have drugs that decrease or inhibit aqueous formation. So from all the drug classes mentioned above, those which are blockers or inhibitors are present in the left column. The example, beta blocker and carbonic anhydrase inhibitors. So the word decrease goes with decrease or inhibit or block. Now the right column have drugs that increase aqueous outflow. So the drugs that are agonists or mimetics or analogs are present in the right column. So the word increase goes with agonist or mimetic. An exception to this that can be remembered separately is that alpha 2 selective agonists, which are agonists but they are present in the left column, and they decrease aqueous formation. Thanks for watching. If you find the information in this video beneficial, do like and share, and do not forget to press the subscribe button. Thank you.